Welcome to another patch that makes me that one more bit a threat to society. That's right, it's the 11.5 patch rundown, where the abundance of bees reflects my grades on a much too personal level. Starting off with champions, if you're one of those 2% of players that play Azir, we'll say hello to competitive nerfs, where Azir will be losing 10 damage on his soldiers. Next up we have Gragas, who will be getting a Q mana nerf. Unfortunately that does not affect his W spam top lane build, which is the real threat of Gragas. Jax will also be getting an AD per level increase, so you can all let out your inner Hashinshins.
Right through the Counter-Strike!
And if supports weren't already cancerous enough to deal with, Karma will be getting a 1 second reduction on her Q, just so she can poke you that little bit more, along with Kog'Maw getting a buff just so Raya can sell some more skins. And Master Yi will be getting a small buff on his E, so if you're less than gold, you better be banning him. Obviously, because we're on the theme of buffing supports, Pyke's health storing mechanic will be reworked to work with lethality and work better when there's two enemies in lane, obviously buffing Pyke's support. Overall increasing the throw support picks in the next coming patches. Qiyana is getting an all-round buff, but unless you're located in China and your rank is greater than Masters, this probably doesn't matter to you. Rammus is getting a HP nerf, okay. Wireless Rell managed to find some similar nerfs for herself, making her less tanky. So now she's a less tanky tank. Still a tank though. And Riot realized that maybe gutting Samira wasn't the smartest play, so now they're returning some of her power in different form. She will now be doing more melee damage. Just what Samira needed. Oh, and she gets more AD per level. Cool. And Riot managed to buff Sejuani again without her play rate ever increasing. Sona clone Seraphine is getting a small change on her passive, resulting in less damage from its interactions, but more base damage overall, with a small hit to her ult CDR in the early game. And if you hate Shaco's support, well good for you, because Shaco's getting buffed in the jungle. You might see him less. Possibly. And apparently Riot decided to put Trundle off his diet, so now he will be eating more, and therefore chomping you that 0.5 second more often. And AD Twitch will be buffed because apparently Twitch wasn't supposed to be a wizard. And wait, what's this? Udi is getting nerfed, but it won't affect his win rate? Hold up, that can't be right. Never mind, it's Riot. Apparently Riot didn't realize that reason Udi was strong was because of the tank items. And therefore they nerfed his base damage on his ult. Fun fact, that would work if it was a larger amount and they changed his AP scaling to be increased. Therefore, he would be building AP rather than tank, and therefore Udyr might be balanced. And if you thought we were done, well, we're not, we have items now. Here comes the only change that I possibly agree with, but Manamune will be getting changed, with better scaling overall for melee champions. Guinsoo's Rageblade will no longer stack past 100% crit, not that it really matters because Yasuo and Yone can no longer build the item either way. And if you love playing against Darius, well now you won't because Stridebreaker is getting a 100 range increase, wireless the slow and damage is decreased, reducing more counterplay than ever before. Not to mention that, but Black Cleaver is also getting changed, so it gives movement speed instead of percent max health damage, making Darius love you even more. All jokes aside though, if you don't want a big brawny man on top of you 24/7, you may want to ban Darius, considering he will be faster than Sonic the Hedgehog next patch. But if you swing that way, then be my guest. And if your favorite stat was anti-heal, well then maybe your new favorite stat will be anti-shield. Serpent's Fang has a new passive, decreasing the size of shields, which is another big hit for Enchanter supports. More of Malmordius will be a little bit cheaper now, making mages hate their lives that little bit more. Verdant Barrier, I'm looking at you. And now for the only part of the patch that matters, skins. Riot will be releasing 3 new skins and a VFX update for Hecarim. These skins include Beemore, UB, and Beezahar. These names flat out feel like I'm solving some quadratic equation in my head while saying them. All of these skins may look cute, but be warned! Bees can sting, and so can your wallet. And Hecarim's ult looks cool. As always, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. And if you want to see some of my other content, check out my channel and consider subscribing to stay notified about future uploads. My name is Blue Plays, and have a great day.